Here's our VMware environment, and I'm looking at the entire environment in my case, although I can filter it using this to look at smaller parts of it. We'll talk about that in a little bit of time. Each one of these shows me problems and issues that are going on in this time period here. So you can see the little filters I've got. If I wanted to look just at virtual centers, I could see that I've got four warnings. If I'm looking at my virtual machines, I have 24 in a problem state and others, but I have more information here. I can see a list of the alarms, and I can customize these views if I want. So if you want to see this maybe a little bit more easily, let's do this. You'll notice here at the bottom there's a little export feature. So wherever you see these customizers, you can export what you see in one of these formats. Moreover, as you go through this, you get the option to save it as a more regular report. And I'll come to that shortly as well. Perhaps more importantly on this screen, you can see here the performance scores for each of the virtual environments that we have. The lower this number, the worse the performance is. Clicking on this, you can see it. Well, in fact, before we click on it, you can see that the first bottleneck here is memory utilization. It is bottlenecked at 100%. Sometimes you'll see more than one bottleneck in the environment contributing, but so you can get the detail by clicking on it and having a look in greater detail. And here we can see it is just on memory utilization that's an issue. If I wish to, I can drill down into this so we can actually go and have a look in more detail. And here we are, we can see our memory utilization at 100%. And we're in a more detailed monitoring view of the world at the moment. And from here, we can see other key things about this particular virtual machine. So you can see some messages. This one's been moved through from one resource pool to another using DRS. We could do some event analytics on it. So here we are. And you can see the events, which I can overlay onto the chart of metrics over here. So you can see we had these events that occurred at this point in time. And there's an infrastructure change. And these things here have been changed to null, which tends to happen when you've got a shutdown. And another event here. And that's where it started up again. So that's your two events associated with this DRS move. We won't go through all of these in turn, but there are some sort of insights you can get into these. You can look at the storage for this particular one. And we could explore these in more detail if we want to. I'll come back to storage in a little while. But you'll see it also looks at the other virtual machines that are sharing the same storage environment. And you can see what they're doing in terms of I.O. We could go down through its network topology, the processes running on it. Administration would allow us to go and do things to this one, so you can actually start and stop the virtual machines. We could review its cost, and we'll come back to these SAN ones in just a second. I'm going to go and pick out something a little different here. We're going to go back to the whole VMware environment for this one, this subset that I was looking at. So we're going to go and find that. It'll be down at the bottom of my list somewhere. There we are. And now that I'm here, I'm going to search for a particular virtual machine just to show that I can really. You can see the list filters as I went, and I found an individual virtual machine. I'm now going to go and have a look at that one. So here's my monitoring for it. You can see the related items. Those above it, the basic resource consumption, configuration information, anything about its data protection. And over here you'll notice we have cost information about it too. I'm going to explore through to this one, and we're going to come back to this from another angle shortly. So I said I'd go and have a look at SAN topology and SAN data paths. If your virtual machine is running on a piece of storage, physical storage that is, which is being monitored by our physical storage component, which is here, then you can see this SAN topology right the way down from the virtual through your data store, through your volume out to your cloud of storage devices, and here's the individual LUN. Now, if I click on this, I can monitor my way through, you'll see this one here, more information about it pops up. If I wish to, I can go from here, and that will take me down into the storage device monitoring in more detail. And I'm going to come back to that in another place, because we'll show you how we can do that all over again from another angle. So here you are, you also get your SAN data paths. So you'll see there's been a little bit of latency at some point over it over the time. And so see, we have had some latency issues. All right. Okay, let's come away from that and go back to our virtual environment. Just so we can see a few more things about these, about this. This is our monitoring one. You can see it at different levels. We've looked at virtual machines. There's a similar sort of view, if you like, based on data stores. This one I said would filter, so if I just want to see the thing with a warning against it, I can. There we are, little detail. If I pick out this one with some fatal error, there's my fatal ones. And you can see here there's those time to fall alarms I was talking about previously. We can go and have a look at higher levels of data centers. You'll see I have this explore button, which will take me to more detail if I want to pick out one of them in particular. So if I want to pick out this one, I can explore down into more detail. And here I am. And now I have some performance, so I'll be able to see the VMs on here and some information about storage. All right. Not going to go any further than that. In here, here are all my virtual machines. This is an analytics view. Yep. So here I have a heat map, and this is using my CPUs. CPU used is my size. CPU utilization gives me my color, and I can have virtual machines that have alarms in them, so I can, so I don't have to do all of them. And again, I can click through to go and see what's going on, and you can see the utilization and things in here. All right, so there's a little overview of monitoring. I'll just click through some of the other environments so you can see what they look like. We do something very similar for Hyper-V, almost identical except for the architectural differences between the two. I'll come back to storage in a moment. Cloud environments, VMware view environments, Xen desktop ones, Active Directory. We can browse your Active Directory environment around here, and we can view in an Explorer if we wish to, so we can drill down into the different views of what's going on. We do the same for Exchange and Office 365. We monitor some of our own networking and other people's, not networking. We monitor some of our own data protection products, NetVault and Rapid Recovery, just to show you what those look like. There's a NetVault server, so you can see what failed jobs and activity there are. Same for Rapid Recovery. Interestingly, we also do Veeam. And then we've got these sort of utility ones for monitoring logs and web services, or not web services, websites. So you can see here I've got a couple of them going on. And if I open that up, you'll see I can look from different places. And we can see what those actually look like. With locations, and here are my transactions through, and you can see we're just monitoring a series of different websites out there to see if they're alive, and you can go through those down to other bits. Some of the more diagnostic type views in here, you've got another VM, right? We have the heat map, you've got a scatter chart, so you can use these things to see which are the outliers. So in this case we're looking at ESX hosts. And we're looking at the CPU capacity by CPU used. So you can see in here, we've got several of them quite small. And in here, but out here, you'll see we've got some outliers that are at one end or the other. And again, I can drill down to have a look at them from there. So really quick way to go about it. You'll see there are slightly different tabs across here.